now. Oh,
you know what? I don't think I need to share my patented Fringy Goo secrets with you.
You could just stay, like, if there's like a room where you can just fly to the edge and they can't reach you, just fucking fly around the room with the Fringy Goo.
Fringy Goo?
Mm-hmm.
Fringy Goo?
No.
Fringy, have you been putting your goo in places?
I told you not to do that.
No, I don't just put my goo anywhere. I keep it stored safely in the fridge.
Ew.
With padlock on it.
The
with
goo fridge.
No.
Rags of snow.
Yeah, Rags of snow and Fringy's goo. Get a 2-for-1 discount.
Well,
just today only.
Just keep your goo away from my snow. I like my snow pure and white.
That's racist.
You don't even know what the goo does. How dare you?
Exactly. That's what. Exactly. I don't know. I have no clue.
Yeah, but you assume that the goo would make the snow impure.
Well, it's in the freezer.
Yeah, of course it would, because it's not snow.
How do you know that the goo isn't just snow?
Because it's goo. You specified it was goo.
Yeah, I know it's goo, but that could be snow goo.
Here's the thing. I don't believe that you can have snow that's also goo. I don't even know if that's possible.
I don't.
Isn't that just called slush?
You believe it? I don't.
Well, here's the thing. I'm open to the intermixing of the goo and the snow. But wow, this has become quite the coded conversation. But you're gonna have to explain to me what the. I need to learn more about this goo before I open up my snow.
You know what? I don't think I need to share my patented Fringy Goo secrets with you.
Oh no, I don't Everybody need secrets. Buy, just like yeah. what it does. You know, what'll it do to my snow?
That's part of the mystery. All right.
All right.
Bring the Daphne's goo.
Yeah, well, I guess my snow
point,
will be over here, and
yeah,
your goo will be over there, and that'll be that.
If he's not going to know anything about it, he probably wouldn't want to risk putting his snow next to the goo, would he?
What if it's one of those chemicals that reacts violently to water or to cold temperatures?
Yeah. Well, it would be weird he's putting it in a fridge if that was the case.
Well, snow is colder than a fridge.
Well,
quote
depends.
Me on that.
You can set a fridge.
Well, then,
it would be a freezer.
It wouldn't be a fridge.
You put a fridge in the Arctic during winter? It would still
then
be a fridge.
Because the internal temperature is that of a fridge. It's below or it's above freezing. That's what Eskimos do to keep their food from freezing. They put it in the fridge.
It's not plugged in.
Fuck you mean?
Sorry. Oh, if it's not plugged in, it will eventually get to freezing, and then it will become a freezer.
Well, no, because there's the fridge at the top and then the refrigerator at the bottom. It doesn't mean that the fridge is any less of a fridge just because it's in the snow.
So here's the thing, if you left it in the Arctic, they would both become freezers.
Since when did we define the difference between a fridge and a freezer as the temperature rather than just the creation of the thing itself?
I am concerned.
If you put an oven
probably
in the
primarily with
does it become
effects?
A freezer?
Freezer.
Sure. Yeah, if the inside of it, if it is a object used for,
Box?
If it's an object with a door, and you open it up and it's freezing inside and it keeps things frozen, I mean, if it looks like a duck, smells like a duck, I don't know what ducks smell like, but duck was my first word, you know?
The definitions of these things are not based on how cold the apparatus gets.
Look at my oven,
it's a freezer.
It's really hot.
So,
if you gave me
a box with a door and I opened it up and it was freezing and you said this is an oven, I'd be like,
yeah, I'd be like, it's not a freezer either. It's a box that's cold.
Yeah.
I don't know if it keeps things cold, that might. I mean, it's weird that it has grates in it.
I would agree it can achieve similar things to a freezer, but
I would say that it becomes a freezer.
I would say meaningfully we have very specific criteria for what a freezer is.
That it doesn't
involve simply a box that freezes things.
I feel like that's really the massive bulk of what a freezer is a box that freezes things.
If I stack four walls in the Antarctic in any way, shape, or form, or I guess five.
Does that become a freezer?
It's a freezer. Is there
if
such
a
thing as an
if
igloo,
it has a door,
or is it just
if you put a door on it, An igloo doesn't keep things frozen. The point of an igloo is that it traps the heat in. That's what I'm saying. Depending on the usage of it, I would be fine.
So the answer was
yes.
Not all the stuff you just said.
No, I was right.
No. You said an igloo would be a freezer, and you said no. It would be because it heats stuff.
Well, I was just in the sense that's what an igloo, because when you say an igloo, if you're talking about using an igloo for that purpose, I'm fine with having a freezer.
You would call it an oven.
I'm scared, metal.
Yeah.
Because an igloo, I don't know if an igloo can be an oven, because I don't know if it could survive that temperature.
This all started with Fringy's goo.
As long as it's heating something compared to the outside, right? Because temperature is relative.
Yeah.
Temperature is relative, we have ways to measure. Like, we can measure in Kelvin. Kelvin isn't relative.
Rags, if I put a box
hot and cold
space...
is relative, Rags.
Yes, hot and... Yes, hot and cold are relative. Temperature is not.
So, what is the temperature threshold for an oven? Please tell me.
I don't know about an oven, but I think it has to be... I think that we can all agree that an oven would have to get to temperatures that are... hot enough to melt ice.
But
I think we can agree on that, right?
So a house is an oven because it can be warm enough that if you put
a
glass...
door.
No. Yeah. I'm starting at a level and then we're gonna progress from there, right? Because I was asking if you'd agree. Like, it has to at least be that hot. I don't know about an oven, but I think a freezer has to be below.
A fridge can melt ice. What are you talking about?
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. That's the point of the distinguishing between a freezer and a fridge.
No, we were talking about an oven and a freezer, not a fridge.
Which one? Okay, so which one would you like to know about?
Threshold for an oven?
I'm not sure specifically, but I think that we can all agree on a decent threshold.
You say that we can agree, but you're not giving me anything.
I was just asking if you could probably think about it, what would be the threshold? I would say I don't know in specific degrees, but I think I could find out and we can work our way from there. Because generally you don't have to know the exact temperature of an oven, you just know it's really hot.
But remember, hot and cold are relative. Really hot.
Yeah, I know. That's why we're having a discussion. And besides, the way that we all use ovens are the same species. Using it for the same reasons. So we kind of have the same frame of reference for when we're talking about an oven. And Venus doesn't have to enter into the equation in that sense. So, oven temperatures are. I don't know. I would say. To get to a temperature range of an oven, it says, usually range from 127 Celsius to 227 Celsius. So around 260 Fahrenheit to 440 Fahrenheit. So I would say that's a decent enough starter for an oven temperatures.
So a fridge can be anything between what? Like 0 degrees and 120 degrees Celsius.
No, I don't think so. I think that a fridge would be between right above freezing to, I don't even know. My fridge might have
to get our scale in reference, 120 Celsius above is an oven. Between like, I don't know, like 5 degrees and 120 degrees is a box.
I would say that there's a top level for an oven. I think when an oven gets hot enough, it becomes something else.
I'm talking about below an oven. I don't care about above an oven. We're talking about below
A furnace or a kiln. Actually, I don't know if kilns get hotter than ovens.
What I'm trying to figure out.
A bunch of other things.
Yeah, I would imagine because they're specially built and yeah.
I mean, I make that argument for fridges and ovens, by the way. not just the kiln. The kiln is very specialized, though.
Oh yeah, the kiln is definitely specialized, and I would say that an oven is specialized.
Yeah.
Less specialized, but still specialized.
It's
like
not a
freezer.
Box that's just cold or hot. All right, excellent.
I don't. Within a certain range, I'd say within a certain range. And I would say that if you had a refrigerator, and you cooled that refrigerator down to where it was a sustainable freezing temperature, it would be a freezer and not a refrigerator anymore.
You can have those. Those can exist. That is true.
Yeah. Yes.
I'm so glad we had this conversation.
Yeah,
I'm just feeling like a lot was achieved.
I'm telling you the secrets of my guru, though.
I didn't want to bring that back into the conversation.
That's fine.
But, you know.
That's honestly fine. I feel like you have a right to your intellectual property. My snow is mine, you know. and if you ever feel like giving, just I don't need to know the mechanisms or the construction of the goo or what it is. If you were just, because I think we're on pretty good terms. Yep. So if you just told me what the snow does, like what its effect will be on the snow, that will allow me to make my decision as to whether or not I will allow the mixing of the snow and the goo.
Well, look, in case I want to put my snow in there, have you put your name on your snow?
Oh yes, all of mine is definitely, because I have very special Tupperware containers that I use. They like stack on top of each other and everything.
Oh, so you're happy for them to mix in with the snow, but not goo?
Well, the Tupperware doesn't mix with the snow.
The plastics
will
contaminate.
What if the goo was promised to not mix, to simply like oil and water? You know, it's there, but it doesn't mix with the snow.
So I'd wonder what the point is of putting them together if they don't mix. Like, are we short on space? Like drastically short on space?
Yeah, you really, the fridge is tilted up now, so that, you know, and you just sort of pour everything in and then close it, and it, yeah.
But, will my mint ice cream fit?
That's a good question.
Will ice cream fit?
My mint ice cream, specifically.
I don't think your stuff can go in this fridge. That's fucked up. Yeah, we don't have everyone's stuff in the fridge.
Yeah, the fridge is only so big, and, you know.
It's just a small tub.
It's a Todd fridge.
Just the fact you're calling it a tub is already kind of pushing it to.
And like, Fringy's still piling his goo in there. Like, I don't want to. I want to make sure we get all that into.
It's not a gallon. It's
besides, you don't want to put. Why would you? Wait. Why would you put ice cream in a fridge? You'd put it in a freezer.
Yeah. What the fuck?
Why would you put snow in a fridge? It should go.
Oh, I will tell you. You know what? I'm glad you asked. So, here's the origin of the snow story. It snowed earlier this year. It snowed more than I have ever seen it snow here in my life. Lots and lots of
snow story. We did it on
Easter. Oh well. Okay, I'll give the abridged version. My power went out during the snowstorm. I didn't know when the power would be back on. So as a precautionary measure, I got a bunch of the snow from outside because there was a lot of it. I put a bunch of it in my fridge to help keep the fridge cold for longer if the power didn't come back. So that's why I had snow in my fridge for a long time.
God damn it, I bought the fridge. I can put what I want in it.
If it's your fridge, you can. But if it's not your fridge, then...
When did the law mention it was your fridge? I didn't sign up for this.
No, this is my fridge.
I thought it was your fridge. Yeah, and you were graciously allowed Fringy to store some goo in there, but you just didn't want it to touch the snow.
Yeah. And I assume it would be in its container anyway. So as long as it's, you know, contained, if it doesn't, like, have gases emanating from it. Especially because that would cause pressure issues with inside, where it would, you know, maybe open up the door eventually or...
Well, from what I've heard, it increases mass gradually, so there's a worry.
You might want to. Oh,
there is a worry
there. Outside.
You won't even tell me what his goo does.
It's
It makes
really
your goo
important.
Seem nefarious, honestly.
The goo is not. I am a plague doctor. I help people. All right.
Help people, huh?
Yeah.
Do you help? Wait. Actually, it sounds like you got that. Backwards? Like, are you a plague doctor because you help people, or you help people because you're a plague doctor?
What do you mean?
Is plague doctor descriptive or prescriptive for you?
I would say that when it comes to what it means to be a plague doctor, it's about helping people. So yeah, it's descriptive. It's not prescriptive.
Okay, well, I've got a big counter argument to that. I watched this show about like ghosts and stuff, and there was like this plague doctor ghost, and he was really scary, but he didn't turn up at all really in the end to fight the heroes. Destroyed the whole show. There was this sort of shot of him looking kind of suspicious, and then they didn't have him fight all the heroes at the end, so...
Why would he fight? He's a plague doctor, he doesn't fight people, he
he was evil, he was definitely evil.
Even though
doctors
we
can
saw
fight.
In episode 8 that he wasn't a bad guy.
No, there was the camera angle, he looked at one of our heroes, he was evil.
Is it evil for plague doctors to look at people?
Yes. It's borderline.
That is offensive.
Well, I will say, Fringy, you do look a little upset. Like,
huh?
Like, you do look a little.
This is a still image. This is a still. Yeah, I look,
okay.
Right.
Still images look a certain way.
Yeah, I don't know, Mola. You look a little bit deranged there. And Rags,
I'm looking curious.
I don't know what that look is, Rags, but it's
you know exactly what this look is.
What about a plaque, Doctor?
I would feel a little more safer with Rags' face looking at me than you. I feel like I've crossed you somehow. I'm like, oh.
I feel like my cards are on the proverbial table. All right, yes. I know exactly. Hey. Yeah, I am using my expressions I'm using them for what they're there for.
See,
I'm communicating.
My expression isn't mad. I'm just
maybe you should take a mask then.
You know, I'm
I have
just
a helmet.
Like,
I don't have a face.
I think
what
you're just
might
upset.
Be wrong with you that I can help with? All right, that's me.
Well, you won't tell us what your goo does. I don't know.
See, when you add these things together, there is a concern.
It's not responsible to talk about the goo. It's my goo, and I will disclose what it
does.
Well,
it may be
why'd
your
you
goo,
bring
but
it up?
You're putting it into Rags' fridge.
What
though.
Do you mean bring
yeah,
it up? Somebody else brought it up, didn't they?
Your goo?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure someone else brought up my goo.
You brought up
the
goo.
You could have said, I don't have any goo. That would be a weird thing for a plague doctor to have. Why
so
would I have
you
goo?
Would prefer for me to... You would rather that I lie about the goo. Is that...
You would... No. The goo right there, that was Schrodinger's goo before you confirmed it.
Oh, no.
Maybe there's goo in Fringy's possession. Maybe there isn't. I don't know.
It's
Schrodinger's goo.
Rag said, why would a plague doctor have goo? It's like, there's a lot of reasons why a plague doctor
there's
could
a lot
goo.
Of reasons why it would, yeah, need goo.
Name four.
Why would have goo?
Yeah, why,
I feel like there's only one reason that it could be useful.
You said there's a lot of reasons why a plague doctor
yeah,
would have
but
goo.
It's,
we've walked that
yeah,
back to one reason.
Well, the one no. reason is an all-encompassing reason that there are many reasons why you would need to use goo.
I gave a specific example. Spell casting, you'll need goo.
Is it goo is used for spell casting? I don't know if I want my snow anywhere near this spell casting goo. What
hey,
if it's it hurts?
I didn't say it was spell casting goo.
Hey.
That's one function of goo.
That's one thing that's you've invented that.
I have to invent what the goo must be. You won't tell us.
Yeah, but you don't need to jump. We gave you one. Yeah. We're gonna give some more. But
the
you know,
spell casting.
Is that how your mind works, Rags? Anytime you
no,
see something you
said
don't
spell
understand,
casting.
You jump to the... I didn't say spell casting. Mola said
that was
spell
one
casting.
Example.
So it is an example of what it can do.
Yes, but it doesn't necessarily mean
what
that's goo could
do
is for.
Yeah.
So the goo could be used for spell casting.
As could snow.
I don't know if it can be. I don't think spells are real. I don't think spells are real. I don't
okay,
think
well,
that
now,
snow
now
can be
now
used
we're really
for spell
getting
casting.
Into it, aren't we? This is where it all came down to. You just never even agreed that spells were real.
I don't agree that spells are real. I can maybe you can use your goo to convince me if that's not a company secret or something.
Are you
okay? Well, I can't do this. The goo isn't mine. It's
listen, I feel like I just need if you just tell me more about this goo. You're being awfully evasive. It's kind of
I'm not being evasive
off.
At all. I'm just I'm being pretty honest. How is it evasive to tell you consistently that I don't want to talk
you're
about what the goo
you,
is?
That's you're being very evasive right now.
It's not evasive. I like how the definition of evasive is what is the goo
you
do?
Refusing to answer
say,
questions.
But it's not evasive because I'm being honest. I don't want to tell you what the goo does.
That sounds
like
evasion to me.
How is it evasion? I'm answering your question.
No, you're not.
You're
telling me why. You're telling me why you won't. You're telling me why you won't answer my question. You're not answering my question.
I don't.
I want to know about this goo.
I agree with Rags on this point.
That's the problem.
You're
I want to know about this goo.
This point. If you surely. Ask somebody, give me this answer, and they say, no, I won't, that's not evasiveness. That's just straight out telling you that I'm not going to say what it is.
Well, you're evading the original. No. You're giving an answer,
but
you're
not,
evading.
So
no,
evasiveness
no, 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 no,
like,
no, 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 hold on, hold on. You're evading the original question by giving an answer that's not directly related to it.
Your unwillingness to tell me about this goo, it doesn't give me good vibes. I don't feel secure having my snow next to this goo.
I
want to protect my snow.
That is evading the answer. If you get asked a question and your response is, this question is not applicable, that's not evasion. The question is, what is the goo? My answer is, I'm not telling you what it is. That's not evasion, especially when I'm being very clear.
I don't know.
Well, it doesn't answer the original question. It does not answer the original question.
I'm curious why you won't tell me.
The original question.
It makes me feel like this goo is nefarious.
No, so if it doesn't answer the original question, then you're evading the question.
I mean, it wouldn't matter. Rax can just say, you're not answering. I'm not getting the answer I want. That's all he has to say to end that.
Yeah, which is,
you know, and I understand the desire to know what the goo does. I do understand why you'd want to know.
Yeah. I feel like... Yeah,
I'm aware of a couple of things goo can be used for, like spells, but I don't know. I don't know what.
I like the
goo
idea
for.
That you could
not all spells are good.
Company...
That's all I'm saying.
Yeah, but not all snow can be used for good things.
But it is snow being used for good things.
Oh, is it now?
Well, then why are you?
Yeah, it is.
The goo won't be. Why?
Because it without any sort of explanation whatsoever, I can't assume the best
trust
for the protection
he's
of
telling you.
Because of no, he's not.
Well,
he's not
Fringy,
telling
is
you what
to
use for.
Can you tell us if it's being used for good or evil?
Of course, it's being used for good. I'm a plague doctor.
There you
That's
go.
What we Fringy? Do.
Good. Wait, good from your perspective. Will it be good for my snow or just?
Oh, what does good for your snow mean?
Okay,
what do you think?
If it melts my snow, it's not good for my snow. If it ruins the purity of my snow,
we'll see. You changed it from. Before you were
I'm giving you multiple criteria. I'm giving you multiple criteria because more than one bad thing can happen to you, and so more than one thing can happen to snow that's not good.
Okay.
So if it melts the snow,
it's bad if your snow would melt from being in contact with the goo.
Yes, not only it would destroy my snow.
Well, no, just change it into water.
which means it wouldn't be snow anymore.
It would still be
and then
water,
if you tried to refreeze it, would just turn into an ice block, which is lame.
Oh, I see.
I want my to remain in a healthy...
I don't know, it depends on what type of snow you have, and also, I haven't tested with all types of snow.
Can we run experiments? Are you willing to part with some snow for this?
Yeah, because I need some snow to know what my goo will do to the snow.
If we conduct a single
will
spell,
it give the snow herpes?
I know what my goo does in other cases, but I've never tested
other
with snow because I've never felt compelled to test with snow.
If you had to make an educated guess based on those experiments as to what it would do with snow, what do you think it would do?
you're admitting to ignorance of testing?
No, because I tested it for... So... I want you to think about what you just said. Like, would you be testing, like, whether or not a vaccine is useful as jet fuel or something? Like, why would you
Maybe.
Be testing these things that you don't think about?
You've had a lot of it.
My answer, ultimately, is, in my educated opinion, but again, I can't say for sure, I'm pretty sure that the goo would not melt the snow, but it might change the properties of the snow.
Well, maybe the goo is like the,
Well, that's unacceptable to Rags, I think.
Yeah,
if it changes the properties for better. Oh, I'm interested. Tell me what in what way would that what would an example
well,
of that
I
be
mean,
changing
sure,
the properties of the snow?
Presumably, presumably you would be happier if the snow didn't melt like at all, right? You
it's already
well,
in that position.
If it melted it wouldn't be snow and then I would be upset.
I mean the idea that if there was like a power outage and it screwed with your fridge that you could rest assured that the snow wouldn't melt. That would be a positive change, right?
Can the goo do this?
Like keeping the snow perpetually at below freezing temperatures?
Well what I'm saying I'm not saying that the goo would necessarily do this. I'm just saying that the properties of the snow could be changed in ways that are better, that's possible.
I don't even know if that's possible. What criteria would it be?
I think that's possible, right? Isn't salt water
maybe.
have a lower freezing point than fresh water?
I don't want to make the snow impure by salting it.
The interesting thing I think here is that Fring's almost suggesting like he could keep with the goo potentially the snow could remain snow in all temperatures, which is a pretty cool upgrade. But does that kind of make it not your snow at that point because it's a different thing?
I'm fine with the properties of my snow changing in a way that I find is sufficiently advantageous.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And if
like
you
I
think
said,
that
I
you're
tested it.
Well, the have can you reason? Could you reason? Well, I don't know. We don't know if it could or not. I feel like the possibility that that could even be possible should be something you can demonstrate. Because I've got snow on the line, and that stuff doesn't just fall from the sky for free.
No.
Well, that's true. You know what? I might need to do some extra testing, and I'll get back to you on
the. Tell you what, if you can, you get an ice cube or something. Because my snow is in the fridge right now, keeping my fridge cold. So if you go up to the top bit, or maybe it's down at the bottom for backwards Australians, you can get an ice block or an ice cube, and maybe you can use that for some preliminary like a lab rat version of snow. And you could use that, and you could see what its effects are. And
I'll give it a shot. I have another question.
What
drinks?
Okay.
Is your goo like the structure gel from Soma? Does it have multiple purposes?
Whether that purpose is embedded or not? Don't oil Soma, please. I don't know yet about that.
Oh, right. Fuck, I'm sorry.
He's not giving away anything about his goo.
Don't worry. I get nothing from that. I don't know what that means.
The last question I have is, where are you going to be storing this while you're running these tests?
What, my goo or my...
Yeah, because the fridge is off limits by the sounds of it.
Will your goo be able to... if you have a whole lab, then why do you even have to... What's the whole point of this? If you could put it in your lab this whole time.
There's a lot of goo, and I got a lot of stuff in my lab that I need to do.
I don't know about you guys, but like... It seems like Rag's fridge is not going to be enough if you've overflowed your entire laboratory.
I don't know how big my lab is. It could be the size of a closet.
How is that a lab? How is a closet a lab?
Look, I'm a dog. I know a lab when I see one. Right?
I'm not saying my lab is the size of a closet. I'm just saying that a lab could be the size of a closet.
Well, what worries me about all that is that it implies that in a time of space shortage, your goo will be one of the first things that you have leave the lab, which implies to me it's not all that great. Or else you would have kept it in the lab.
My equipment is of the top priority, and then you go down from there in terms of what can move, right? So like the things you've already made, you can move out of the lab, but the equipment that's a important
part of
the lab.
Well, what about beakers and Florence flasks and things like that? That you can put those pretty much anywhere. Yeah, you can put those pretty much anywhere, but I feel like the goo itself
I can't do experiments if that stuff is not in my lab, whereas I can do experiments on other things without the goo. The goo is not the most important thing that I'm working on.
It seems like something that you just want to really keep, under lock and key, you know?
I can lock it up elsewhere, but, like, I don't need to keep it in the lab at all times.
Do you think it should be locked up?
I never said that. You said.
Well, that's why I'm asking.
I would only lock it up to prevent people from stealing the goo. That's the thing. Not because like I need to keep
the
goo.
On a farm.
Yeah.
I made the goo.
Can I have some?
It's a proprietary thing. I made the goo.
So can I pay you for some then?
Not right now. I'm still developing it. I'm still.
Is there petroleum in the goo?
What?
I'm not gonna tell you what's in the goo.
Wait. Can I use my position as producer of EFAP to secure some goo for consumption?
It's not EFAP. It's the goo is not an EFAP project. It's a Fringy project.
How much you want for it?
I don't want anything for it. I'm a
doctor. It might not be worth anything.
I don't do this for money. I do it for the pursuit of science.
Can I use it to fuel my ship?
Can I be an experiment?
The properties of it. No, I'm not.
Is it because I'm Mexican that you won't use me as an experiment?
I don't know why you had to go there. But that was not anything I was thinking about at all. I'm not a racist plague doctor. They went out of style a long time ago.
Hey, can I beat the experiment?
Oh, hey.
But anyway, I'm not talking about my goo anymore. I think we've reached a good end point here.
What about your goop?
Hmm?
What about your goop?
You're mistaking me for Gwyneth Paltrow. I don't have any goop.
Paltrow?
I see. Wink. No goo. Wink.
Stop winking. It's disgusting.
No. Fuck you.
I don't.
Wow,
have
I say one thing and then I just get set up. Okay, fuck you.
I don't. Yeah, but I'm not talking about my go anymore. That's my business.
See, chat. That's what happens. Your stream gets hijacked. You say one thing, and the first thing you get told.
It's your business
you.
Until you want to put it next to my snow, and then we have to have a discussion.
Yeah, fair enough. But we have the discussion, so you know.
We can separate like it with my ice cream. We'll put my ice cream in between you two. It'll be fine. We just shove my ice cream in between them, and it'll be fine.
Oh boy, quad shot. Oh, this is gonna. This is, oh, should be fine.
Little stream had its chance.